gentlemen, we can rebuild him. We have the technology. Better. Stronger. Faster.
It's Tom from Texas, and it's time for round two of trying to fix this old Commodore 64. If you haven't checked out my first video of my first Commodore 64 repair, you can check out that video right here. Last video, I replaced the PLA chip. And so this time we're trying to figure out which chip I need to go to next for the sluggish and slow issue that I'm having. So I'm going to break out the diagnostic testing, try to play some games on it using a cartridge, and see if we can figure out which direction we need to go next. So go ahead and follow along, and let's see if we can figure out how we can get this thing working again. So I got this cool diagnostic and dead test from Bill Pelton online. And so I am going to now, you try this out, now that I can actually get a screen and see if it could tell me what else is wrong with this thing. As you saw, it was flashing really, really slow. I don't know if it even works yet, but I mean, at least I got a blue screen, which is actually pretty cool to know I got that far. So anyway, let's get this in here and give it a shot. See if it turns on. So we got it to turn on. And I'm just going to run it through this test. I'm still learning about this test too. So I'm just trying to see. Ooh, it's showing me some stuff's bad. Bad cassette, bad control port. Bad U1, bad U2, bad. But I don't know if that's really bad because I did the same test on my C64C, which working just fine, and it did show the same exact thing when I did it. So I don't know if I know exactly if how to read this. Like I said, I'm still learning how to use these tools, but at least it's telling me my RAM's okay and my PLA that I just swapped out's okay, and all that is okay. Just says my cassette, which isn't hooked up, control port, serial port, user port's bad. It says U1, U2, and U18's bad. I'm not sure what those tie back to. I'm sure I could do research and find out. And I think it runs through a few times here. So I'm just going to let it run through a few times. I'm going to do some more playing with this. I'm going to change the camera angle a little bit so this thing isn't so wobbly, and get this computer back together and do some more testing and share with you while I test this out. All right, got the case back around and all put together here. Let's get the power back to it again. Hooking it up to speakers so I can have some sound to test the SID chip. And I accidentally unplugged my S cable. Let's try this again, see if we get the picture. There we go. You see how the square just disappears? My others don't do that. Stops flashing. It didn't let me type anything. In fact, this hasn't worked in a while, but it definitely has this like hesitancy to it. That's the right word. This QWERT. Show how the keys work. It's like it's almost feels like it's warming up. The more it warms up, the better it gets. Let's hook a drive up to it. Let's see what it does. Trying to load something on the floppy. It seems to be talking to the 1571. All right. I don't have any fast load or anything in here, so I'm just loading it the slow fashion way. So it's going to take a little while to get it load up. I have a feeling it's not loading. Let's just stick to our diagnostic testing. See if it can tell us anything that's going on. So one of the things that I want to bring to y'all's attention while this is going on
is down in the bottom right hand corner. You see those times down there? I did a little research and I found out those times down there supposed to be exactly the same. And as you could see, mine is far from it being exactly the same. That's what's causing, you know, the issues are my timing being off, the sluggishness and everything being off. The other thing you see just popped up with the timer. Look at timer 1, A and B. It shows B is bad. If you saw earlier in this video when I did the diagnostic testing, that it all had okay, but now that B is bad. And so I've done a little bit more research on that too, and it seems to be tying back to the 6526 chip. I've learned you got two of those. So they both control the timing, and that's something that I think that I need to look at here, because obviously, as you can see down the corner, that timing is completely jacked up. It doesn't do another round of diagnostic testing right now. It won't even go to count number zero. It just sticks right here because it can't go any further. And so it just continues to do that weird clock movement down the bottom. So my goal is, as I'm now, my plan is I'm going to swap out my 6526 chip. I have two of them, and one of them is socketed. So that's the one I'm going to swap out. I've got a good one that I've ordered, and it came in. And so I'm going to swap that out and see if that makes a difference, and seeing if that timer gets fixed. The one that I cannot swap out at the moment is the one that's soldered directly to the board. So I'm hoping by switching this 6526 chip that's socketed, that it will allow me to fix all the problems that I'm having. So let's go ahead and give that a shot. I'm going to get this keyboard taken back apart again and do a little maintenance inside. So let's take a break for a minute.
So I got my keyboard back apart, and over here are the CIA 6526 chips that I was telling you. One's socketed, one's directly on the board. So I am going to swap out my chip and put in the other one and give that a shot to see if that can help my timing issues that I'm having. So let's go ahead and do that. So this is the new one that I just got. And so I'm going to give that one a shot that I'm going to put in. I'm going to try to do this one-handed while I'm holding the camera. And this is usually pretty simple. See how quick and easy that is to pull those chips out? I wish my whole board was socketed. That would be like a dream come true. It would make things very, very easy for me. But unfortunately, that is not the case. So I blew that out a little bit. And I am going to put this new chip that I just got back in here, notch up, back into the keyboard, and make sure we get it lined up perfectly before we push it in, notch up, everything's in the right place, and just put it down. So now I have inserted the new CIA chip, 6526, like I said, I'm hoping that's going to fix any and all issues that I have, if I'm lucky, fingers crossed. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's turn this thing back on, get the diagnostic cart back in, and you can watch with me to see if it makes any difference. The big thing I want to watch is down in the corner, and that's a good sign. You see my time down there? They're both exactly the same. Well, one's a.m., one's p.m., but my timing's staying the same, where before you saw it was all crazy and didn't match. Now they both show 24, so that's a good sign. Same things are bad. I still got bad in timer 1b. So the sound test is actually working now. It never did a sound test before. And look, now the count is actually changing over here and running again. Before I swapped out that CIA chip, this one it could do another run through. My times are still matching, so that's a good thing. Everything's matching up okay. So this CIA chip is actually having a positive impact. So this is a good sign. I'm still concerned about that timer one. B still saying is bad. But here's our 6 second go around. Still shows the timer B. Sound test is going again. So that is some positive improvement. Let's see if we just plug some cartridges in there and see if we could just, if it recognizes games itself without using the keyboard. So let's take a little break and I'll start up again here in a minute. So we're going to try Donkey Kong here. I got the keyboard back hooked up again and everything hooked back on. And let's turn this on. And we've got Donkey Kong. It looks like all the screens working there so far. Let's hit F1. Ooh. So Mr. Kong looks funny. Oh, must be the wrong port. Let's try port 1. Well, the joystick port works. As you can see, the graphics at times are spriting out. Oops. So died there. Definitely issues. Now it's starting to freeze up a little bit. And now it just crashed. Now it doesn't come on at all. So that definitely isn't working. The CIA chip just swapping the one did not fix the issue. I probably could get it going again, but it's probably just going to crash again. So I'm going to shut this off. No need to keep trying when I know it's still not fixed. So let's put the diagnostic card back in here again and give it another go. One last go, see if anything's changed. Hopefully we're not frying anything by doing this, but you know, you gotta test it to see if it works. We'll give it another quick run through. Make sure our timer still at the bottom is running and matching up, and it is. Now, if you guys see anything that I'm not seeing that I should look at, I'm open to anything, please put down in the comments. I appreciate everybody who watches it and definitely everybody who subscribes to my videos. Love sharing this different stuff while I learn, and hope you all are enjoying the videos. I try not to make them too long. Timer's still bad. Time's still okay in the corner, but this time it's not doing a sound check. And the count's not going up now, the timer's just counting. So definitely something still bad and not working like it should. It looks like it's just now the clock timer's going to run. So the next thing, the next plan for the next video, it looks like I'm going to have to get another CIA chip and replace the one that's soldered. So what that means is I am going to look into getting a desoldering kit and I am going to do my first soldering work. So that's all new to me. That's something I've never done before, but excited to do it. So this weekend it's supposed to be cold anyway, so it sounds like it's a good day to just learn how to desolder something, then solder something in. So I'm just waiting on my new chip to come in, and once that new chip comes in, that will be video number 3. So I hope you enjoyed this episode of Floppy Deep Dive. If you did, please subscribe. I was hoping we'd get this working again on this video, but it's just not the case. So it looks like I'm going to need to be swapping out another CIA chip. So I'm going to have to get me soldering equipment and desoldering equipment and trying to get that new chip fixed and get this working again. So until next time, I hope you enjoyed this version of Floppy Deep Dive.